slide which says ente booth ente abhiman. So I want every single Congress party worker and leader to feel ente booth ente abhiman. But I also want to add one line from my side, which every single worker and every single leader of the Congress party must feel about his party. Ente booth, ente abhiman, ente party. The Congress party belongs to every single member of its. The Congress party belongs to every single member, every single person who fights for the Congress party. We have started the Shakti program, where all our workers can enroll and talk directly with the leadership. And I asked the workers of Kerala through the Shakti app what they would like me to speak about. And many of you sent your suggestions. I would like to read out some of the suggestions here. Chandresh from Alathur said, we need more women and youth candidates. And this is a sentiment felt by many, many people in the Congress party. I want to assure Chandresh and many other workers like him that the first thing that we are going to do when we win the 2019 election is pass the Women's Reservation Bill in Parliament. And we will ensure that in every election, many more youngsters and women participate. We want to see women in positions of leadership. And I know that the leaders of Kerala are extremely capable, but I want to add a few women to the stage. I want to tell Manoj from Kannur, you raised the issue of farmers, and it is central to the future of our country. The protection of our farmers is the key to India's future. We have forgiven farm loan waivers in the three states where we have won elections, and we have committed that in 2019 we will have a government that will make up for all the crimes that Narendra Modi has done against the farmers over the last 5 years. Niaz from Trivandrum mentioned that it is very important that India builds a low-cost, high-quality education infrastructure. And I want to assure him and many other Congress workers like him that we are committed to increasing the amount of money we spend on both healthcare and education in Kerala and at the national level. We do not want an India where only rich people have access to the best universities and the best hospitals. And I want to tell Joji George from Kottayam, Aruna from Alappuzha, and Sunil John from Ennakulam, that we are going to ensure that Congress workers get pride of place in the Congress party in Kerala and across the country.
Sir, you're okay? I can hear you.
Why don't you come closer here? Mr. Narendra Modi is absolutely intent on dividing this country into two pieces. He wants to create two Indias, one India for the richest people and the other India for farmers, laborers, middle class. He is ready to forgive 3.5 lakh crore rupees for 15 of his business friends, but he is not ready to forgive 1 rupee of India's farm loans. He dilutes Mahatma Gandhi Manrega and the food security bill.
Adeham Mahatma Gandhi Gramina Tollurappu Paddhathiyum Nammude Bhakshya Suraksha Paddhathiyilum Vellam Cherkkiyaan Undayathu.
He destroys the land acquisition bill through which farmers and millions of Indians got the rights to their land. The Congress party has always done transformational things for our country. We do not believe in incremental politics. We believe in transformational politics. When the nation faced a wall in front of it of starvation, of hunger, Congress party broke that wall with the Green Revolution. We brought the entire country together and said we have to solve this problem for the future of our country. And within a decade, India got food security.
നമുക്ക് ഒരു ദശാബ്ദക്കാലത്തിനകം ഞാൻ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഉറപ്പ് നൽകുന്നു ഇന്ത്യ ഭക്ഷ്യ സ്വയം പര്യാപ്തത പൂർണ്ണമായി കൈവരിക്കും.
We gave India the Green White Revolution, made India the largest producer of milk in the world. We did it by bringing together the people of this country. We did the telecom revolution, the computer revolution, liberalization, actions that transformed this country. Mr. Narendra Modi has spent 5 years wasting India's time, telling one lie after another. He promised 2 crore jobs every year to our youngsters. He gives 450 jobs to India every 24 hours. For the last 5 years, Mr. Narendra Modi has provided a maximum income guarantee to 15 of his friends. If you are Mr. Anil Ambani, you have a guarantee to maximum income. You can get 30,000 crores just like that through the Rafael deal. Jobs can be stolen from the people of Kerala, from the people of Karnataka, from the people of Orissa. HAL can be pushed aside and Mr. Anil Ambani can be given a contract in 2 minutes. And for 5 years, the poor people of India have watched this tamasha. Nirav Modi, 35,000 crores. Mehul Choksi, 30,000 crores. Vijay Mallya, 10,000 crores. Lalit Modi. Anil Ambani, 30,000 crores.
Anil Ambani, 30,000 crores.
So now the Congress party has decided, if Mr. Narendra Modi can give a maximum income guarantee to 15 people, we are going to give a minimum income guarantee to every single Indian citizen. What does a minimum income guarantee mean? I want to make that clear. A minimum income guarantee means that, like the Mahatma Gandhi Narega promised and committed, the right to work, and like the right to information committed, the right to information, and like the food security bill guaranteed the right to food, the Congress party government after 2019 is going to guarantee a minimum income to every single poor Indian. We are going to give every single poor Indian direct money in his bank account as a guarantee. It does not matter, my friends, listen to me carefully. It does not matter how much Narendra Modi tries. We are not going to allow two Indias. There is only going to be one India.